In this four-part video series, we wanted to take you guys along as we build our acreage, showing you the steps and processes it takes to build a home and particularly an acreage. First, we'll go over things to think about when you're picking your lot, and then also things to think about when you're placing your home on that lot.
There's a lot of different factors that go into finding your perfect spot for building your very own acreage. For example, having lots of trees might be important to you, or being close to the city might be important to you, or even having maybe a lake or a pond in your backyard might be important to you. For Brad and I and our family, a couple things that made us pick this specific location in Grasswood Estates was not only the close proximity to the city, we're only 10 minutes away, we can quickly run in and quickly run back to the acreage. We also wanted our little girl, Ray, to go and grow up in a smaller school. So being right across from Corman Park School, I can walk her to school, her class size is super small, and it's got that small town feel, even though we're in a development. And those were two of the things that were really important to us.
So when you're looking to build on an acreage or out of town anywhere really, it's really important to think about what you want your house to look like when it's done, landscaped, finished, everything. Because whether you want to do a walkout or whether you want to do a bungalow or what style of house you want will depend on what lot you buy. For example, we didn't want to do a walkout. We wanted to do kind of like a sunken bungalow. So in the front of our house, it looks like it's really sunk into the ground, where in the back, all of the back basement windows are out of the ground. So we needed a specific lot for that. But if you want a walkout, yeah, you need a totally different lot. That would not have worked on this lot that we picked. So you need to know what you want the end product to look like before you even go looking for lots.
So those are some things to think about when you decide it's time to start looking for your lot, and also some things to think about when you find that perfect lot and you need to decide on placement of your home on the lot. So in the next episode, we're going to talk about all the important aspects of framing and some things to keep in mind when you're designing your build.